Hey everyone, these sure are exciting times to be in if you're in the market for a new PC build, especially since we've got the titans of the CPU world, namely AMD and Intel, squaring it off with their Zen 4 Ryzen 7000 series and 13th Gen Raptor Lake processors respectively. Now that 13th Gen has been on the market for a couple of weeks, with gems such as the i5-13600K emerging as the undisputed value champion for a modern PC, building a new PC on the LGA 1700 platform sure sounds like an attractive proposition. With this in mind, for today's video, we'll take a look at a more value-oriented motherboard, sporting the spanking new Intel Z790 chipset, the ASUS PRIME Z790-P WIFI. Let's get started. As a product from the Prime series, I'd say that this board is targeted more at the entry level, placing beneath the ROG series and Tough Gaming series of motherboards. In view of this, it might come across as a little odd to have a high-end chipset in a value-oriented package. Do note that this particular board here supports DDR5 memory, not DDR4, where the Raptor Lake platform supports both DDR4 and DDR5 memory, depending on what motherboard that you choose to purchase. As per the brand identity of the Prime series of product offerings, the Prime Z790-P WIFI comes in a conservative-looking grey and white box, and moving over to the rear, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll run through some of these specs in detail later in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest developments in the PC hardware world. With that, let's get on with it. Opening up the box, we see that the Prime Z790-P WIFI comes with a WIFI antenna right here. Now let's set aside the board for the moment so as to see what other accessories ASUS has included with it. First up, we get two SATA 3 cables right here. And these are accompanied by two packs of M.2 drive screws and standoffs, as well as a M.2 drive rubber pad that adds additional height clearance for single-sided M.2 drives. We also get an I/O shield right here, the motherboard manual, and surprisingly, a DVD driver disc, even though optical drives are becoming a thing of the past. On top of these, we get a quick start guide, as well as an ASUS Web Storage promotional leaflet. Onto the board itself, we see that ASUS has gone for a black and silver color scheme with white motifs printed onto the PCB. It does appear that ASUS has recently adopted a space theme for its Prime series of boards. The motifs printed on this board's PCB seem to be inspired by the solar system, and that might just be the planet Saturn that I spy lurking near the processor socket. Being a value-oriented board, it does not come with an integrated I/O shield design and has silver heatsinks all around. The VRM heatsinks for this board seem pretty decently sized, and ASUS has included 14+1 power stages that are rated for up to 50 amps each. The board comes with a passive heatsink for the Z790 chipset, and a clear indication of the board's entry-level position is the inclusion of a heatsink for just one of the three M.2 drive slots that the Z790-P WIFI comes with. For memory support, the Prime Z790-P WIFI comes with four DDR5 slots with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR5 7200+ standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a single tab design that ASUS calls QDIM. Further down from the RAM slots is a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header, which supports up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. Next to it is a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header. While still on the topic of USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses another USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header, which also supports up to two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. We do also get two USB 2.0 front panel headers located right here, with each header providing support for up to two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Near the USB 2.0 headers is a Thunderbolt add-on card header, which is to be used in conjunction with an add-on card that is sold separately by ASUS. The said card adds Thunderbolt 4 and additional DisplayPort connectors for your PC. Another feature included with the board is a serial port header located right here, which I guess could come in useful for situations that call for the use of legacy PC hardware. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 x16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot comes with the Safe Slot Core Plus feature that, according to ASUS, is a reinforced metal sheath added to a PCIe slot so as to keep a card firmly installed, which I suppose is useful given how heavy graphics cards have gotten nowadays. We also get three PCIe 4.0 x16 slots that operate at X4 mode, as well as a PCIe 3.0 x1 slot. In the storage department, ASUS has included four SATA 3 ports, with all four ports in a straight-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with three PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slots, with the first two slots here supporting NVMe M.2 drives only, and the third slot supporting both NVMe and SATA M.2 drives. For audio, ASUS has gone for an entry-level Realtek ALC897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Realtek's RTL8125BG chip, which provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. The board's Wi-Fi is powered by Intel's AX201 Wi-Fi module, which serves up Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5.2 connectivity. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with 6 fan headers which are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 addressable RGB headers and 2 12-volt standard RGB headers located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, the Prime Z790-P WIFI goes for a traditional I/O layout that utilizes a good old I/O shield. The board comes with a DisplayPort 1.4 connector supporting display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a PS2 keyboard and mouse combo port, 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a USB 3.2 Gen 2x2 Type-C port, audio jack connectors, as well as Wi-Fi antenna connectors. In conclusion, the ASUS PRIME Z790-P WIFI is an unconventional motherboard offering in that it serves up the top-of-the-range Intel Z790 chipset and a sufficient set of modern features such as PCIe 5.0 support for a graphics card and 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, while doing away with frills such as an integrated I/O shield design, a premium audio codec, and so on, so as to create a value-oriented motherboard offering that sits at the low end of the Intel Z790 motherboard spectrum. With the above in mind, one issue to think about is the value proposition that such low-end Z790 boards can offer, especially since previous-gen Z690 and B660 boards are still available new on the market, can be had likely on the cheap with perhaps better features, and more importantly, sport support for the latest 13th generation Raptor Lake processors. In my opinion, if you're intending to build a 13th generation Raptor Lake PC, you may well find that a Z690 or B660 board could do the job just as well as a Z790 board, that is, until they're no longer available new on the market. As of November 2022, the Prime Z790-P WIFI can be had for a price of around $439 in Singapore, or for you international folks, around $240 from e-commerce sites such as Amazon. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.